Florida's authoritarian governor, Ron DeSantis, is finally being sued for his decision to abuse his political powers and attack the Disney Corporation in the state of Florida. Of course, that's not exactly what the lawsuit says, right? The lawsuit was actually brought by a group of Florida taxpayers who are saying that because DeSantis dissolved this special tax district, the Reedy Creek Charter, down for Disneyland, they are now going to be saddled with millions upon millions of dollars in new taxes. The taxes, by the way, are estimated property taxes for the two districts that will now have to eat up the cost that Disney will not have to provide anymore. Property taxes are expected to rise by 20 to 25%. That is a massive increase in taxes for the people that live in that area. But of course, DeSantis doesn't care because those are actually blue areas of the state. So the liberals in the state of Florida are the ones who are going to get screwed. So these individuals have now sued the DeSantis administration saying you can't do this. I support this lawsuit. It also has a 0% chance of success. As much as it sucks, you cannot sue a government, state or otherwise, for making a decision that raises your taxes. They have the authority to raise your taxes. The state government could come out right now and say, you know what? We're raising property taxes by 200% on everybody in the state. And guess what? There's literally nothing you can do about that. They have the authority to do it. And if they do it, you're stuck with it. That's not illegal. It should be. It should be, but it's not. So this lawsuit will not succeed. And that is disappointing, of course. However, there is a way that it could succeed. And the thing is, I haven't read the lawsuit, so I don't know the wording that they have used, because that is going to make all of the difference in the world. If you're suing him for abusing his power, and the abuse of power is what you're saying led to your tax increase, you've got a case on your hands. If you're just saying, hey, he made a decision and now we got to pay more money, you don't have a case. It won't even make it to court. It will get thrown out with prejudice, most likely. But if you're arguing in this lawsuit, again, I haven't read it. I haven't seen text of it anywhere, so I don't know what the argument is in the case. But I'm telling you, if you're suing and you're saying that he abused his power, he went after this corporation for political reasons because they disagreed with him on an issue, and then he decided to punish them and we got stuck with the bill, you might have a case there. Again, might have a case there. This is a tricky situation, right? We know that DeSantis abused his power. But what we're going to need is a good lawsuit filed against them so that we can at least make it to the discovery portion where we can get those internal communications. That's going to be key in this. Those internal communications, if they mention, like, let's punish Disney, if they say anything like that in text messages or emails, if we ever get to discovery on this, that's where you're going to get them. But short of having those internal communications, it's going to be a difficult case to prove, and it's going to be even hard to get to that point to prove that he abused his powers. So again, I'm not totally against this lawsuit. I hope they worded it correctly to go after the abuse of power part, because if not, this lawsuit is dead on arrival. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.